Okay, so I want to take a minute and talk about this step function that we have here. A step function is essentially a piecewise function that has horizontal segments. And you'll usually have an open circle at one end and a closed circle at the other. And the open circle means that particular value is not on that piece, but it's on the next one instead. So step function really does look like steps or a staircase. Okay, so the way the step function is defined, typically, is you have integer outputs, and then you have a certain domain for the inputs, and it's specified using these inequalities. So this first one, you have an output of 1 if x is greater than 0 or less than or equal to 1. And that's represented here on the graph by this first step. So any input greater than 0 but less than or equal to 1 is going to have an output of 1. Any input greater than 1 or less than or equal to 2 is going to have an output of 2. So any input down here, if you have 1.1, 1.8, any real number greater than 1 and less than or equal to 2 will have an output of 2. And the same thing applies for 3 and 4. And there's a little table of values off to the right here to help you think about it. But you know, say, for example, I have an input of 3.74. Well, that'd be right about here. Output would be 4. What if I had 3.73 for an input? Output would be 4. All the outputs would be 4 for any number greater than 3, less than or equal to 4. So what does this function actually do? Let's say you have 0.5 and it makes it 1. If you have 1.5, makes it 2. 2.5 makes it 3. 3.5 makes it 4. What it's doing is it's taking every number that's an input and rounding it up to the next integer. So if you have 1 as an input, your output's still 1. I mean, that's already rounded up to the next integer. But you take any number greater than 1, like 1.1, 1.2, and less than 2, it makes it 2. And any value greater than 2, less than 3, makes it a 3. This rounds up to the next integer. So how can you determine this for other graphs? You really want to look at these endpoints and see whether a value is included or not. You also want to look at the relationship between the inputs and outputs and see for the various inputs in that domain, what is the output going to be? And you just kind of have to look for that pattern and see, okay, what's the pattern with the inputs and outputs? And when you can put that pattern together, hopefully you can explain what that function is actually doing.